Hello YouTube, it's me, Kiddabob, and I'm here to show you something awesome. Back to the Future mod. Shut up, Rum. Okay, so today I'm here in the first DeLorean, model converted over from Crisis by Dima, and it's awesome. It's pretty good, and everything, you know, just look around it. And then, if I do this, F3, car options, gonna open the trunk. Okay, hang on, I need to do this first then. Home, yeah, this is the new mod menu, and then you can do a lot of things. Gonna take off the license plate, look, oh, no, not that one. Home. The license plate goes on and off. Dealer kit mode, I'll show you that in a second. But if I do turn that off again, then I turn on the time circuit. There's a new sound and it does that, and then that's obviously my custom time circuits up there, which is the ones I made, but you can't do custom ones because these are coded in the script. But there we go. Hang on, that wasn't meant to happen exactly like that. Do that again. Turn that off. F3, make sure we can open. I'm typing stuff into the... hang on. Just let me... Yes, that's good, right. And I'm going to close all car doors again, right. Right, and I'm going to time travel so I can actually have an empty fuel thing. Right, yeah, I'm going to time travel just 9:55, 6 a.m, because I don't want to travel when it's night time, because it gets really dark. Right, here we go. Please don't crash, 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 please don't crash. Yay! Straight away, I crashed. That's so annoying. Right, here we go again. Shut up, bro. I'm busy. Right, go. Please actually time travel this time. And I didn't actually see any sparks, so I'm a bit confused there. Time traveled. If you can hear that in the background, I'll turn it down. There we go, I'll turn it down. So there's that, and then obviously after time, if you look at it, they fade away, and now the next thing that comes with this car is the dealer kit mod. Which looks like this. Has custom wheels that I textured myself. I textured all of the stuff on this. And there will be a dealer kit for the two hover, and the three railroad as well. And then it has the custom number plate on the back, says Knight. And there's a dealer kit there. And get up to speed. Oh yeah, it's also got a white digital speedo in the corner as well. Yeah, I'll go to a bit later in the day. Move. Shit. It's also a feature I haven't tried out yet. I'll call it a snapshot. Because it's only me who has it, and the person who makes the models, and obviously the person who scripts it. So yeah. There's that. And then obviously this one has its shut up, Ray. And then I'll do that. I'm actually gonna disable this. There we go. Disabled. Right. There we go. Now I'll turn the time-sync off. Right. Another thing that comes with this dealer kit model is automatic driving. Press end, the end key, and then it goes to the road and it follows the road as best it can, trying to avoid objects. Sometimes it does kind of just head towards the waypoint, as in doesn't follow the roads. It's a bit of a bug right now, we're trying to get that fixed. But yeah, it actually drives all the way to the waypoint. Also, sometimes when it's a long waypoint, it doesn't actually go all the way to the end. Yeah, like I said, it tries to avoid them. There's also a collision thing with these models. You can't actually have them have any damage modeling. And also, when it gets to the waypoint, you can start driving again because it gives you control back. You can't actually control it while it's driving. So yeah, there's that. And then obviously, to get out of this, you would press home. Oh, that does work. So to get out of this, you can press home. Yeah, they don't work yet. Hook? Does the hook work? Nope. Hook? Nope. Okay, then I'll turn the dealer kit mode off. Oh, okay, it doesn't work then. Okay, I'll go back to this one, so that's the original again. Then I'll go to 2. Shut up, Ray. Then this is 2. Same again. It's got the future number plate this time. It's got same wheels. Good headlights. A nice logo there. Everything in here. I'll show you the interior. It's the same for 1 as well, so I might as well just show you this one. And how do you turn the headlights on? Oh, like that. Okay, there we go. Right, so there's all that. Get out of the car again. Right, there we go. Right. Then this one. Oh, actually, I didn't show you one of the things I tried to show during this. Home, get a bit more again. I need to turn the time sinks off when I do that. Right, there we go. One of the things I tried to show you when I was doing this is actually watch the car very closely. A bit anticlimactic because you didn't see it. I'm not going to reveal it until it's seen, or if I don't actually see it, then I'll just tell you. I'll give it another shot, and if it doesn't do it, I'll tell you what it was that you were meant to see. Here we go again. Attempt 2. Let me try again. It really is pretty good. Oh well. we go. It says on the front, "Dear kit, I designed that myself." Right, then obviously I'll go back to 2. Then this one has a open and close fusion animation on it. Back to the future, blah blah blah, all that stuff I've already shown you. And then obviously when you're going fast enough, shut up, bro. Time travels. Right, everyone jumps out the way. But it doesn't really affect anything. Just the wheels on fire, that's about it. The tires do pop. But the tires popping doesn't matter, because what I'm about to show you is, if I just refuel this, then I go to 10, 21st, 2015, and where we're going, we don't need roads. Yes, and the lights aren't coded yet. Is all because that's a really loud sound. Flying mode time travel. And the animation works. Which I've been making this hover model myself. And I've been trying to get the wheels to work. It took absolutely ages and so many tries. But now, it looks amazing. Look at it, it's amazing. It's amazing. Right, land, please. Right, landing. This doesn't actually land easily. When you go close to the ground, it bounces because of the special code that's been added in. That, like, instead of just landing on the ground and you can't do any, you can't move forward or backwards, you actually can go, and you have to go up before you move. Well, you don't have to do that now because it just bounces. And then closing animation. It's a bit slow, but that can be fixed easily. It goes back to this mode. Also, the ice stayed on the hover thing for a bit longer. I don't know if the ice will clear from this one now that it's just, now that this vehicle spawned in with it. But yeah, that's about that for now. Yeah, it doesn't show up for that yet. Then this one, Back to the Future 3 car, which was only recently done, it still has the animation on there. It's got the Back to the Future wheels there. And then, obviously driving. And then, because I'm in 2015 now, I can do this. And then I'm going, I should have done this in 1988. Whatever it was, 1955, sorry. Yeah, in 1955. I should have done that in 1955. 1955. This one. Indians! Although it didn't go this way. It goes, I don't know, but you know. Go the other way, but I'm driving this way. And then, because of certain reasons, you can only spawn this in if you want to drive it around like this. BTTF 3 Railroad. and then it spawns it in. Well, it's only like this for now, and then there'll be a way to actually get it in the next thing, and then obviously you've got your railroad wheels and then all the rest of it. I like how the circuits were done on the front, the time travel circuit. And this one obviously has that ambition as well. Yeah, this one takes a while to get up to speed. Yeah, I'm gonna use the boost. Time travel, please. That was a big explosion. Train fell, kaboom. Not my fault. Goes along the rails, just going like this. Just going. Then all of a sudden the train. And then. Give me a sec. Play God Mode on. Oh look, the cops right there. Give me a sec, cops. I'm trying to blow up this car because that's what happens. It gets blown to smithereens by a train. Eh. Blow up. Badoosh. Well, it can't really be blown to smithereens in this, but yeah, that's what happens. And then, like a pro, you press 2. Maybe you reload the script. Sorry, after that minor inconvenience. And after watching the footage back, I know that my voice was quiet, like too quiet. And actually what I was gonna say is, you press 2, like a boss, you press 2 to escape from the cops. You obviously, because I have only just loaded the game in, disable trainer, you press 2, plus, you go to October 21st, 2015. Reload. Obviously you'll have to stand at the back and then press tab to reload that in the future, which is actually something I'm going to show you next. And then you switch to hover mode. Turn around. I'm using a boost. The boost is from a different mod. This isn't part of that mod. It isn't part of this mod. I'm just repeating myself because I don't think you would have heard it because of the loud sounds. But that's how you escape like a boss. There we go. And then, this should have a reload animation. But that'll need to be sorted out. I'm pretty sure if I press... No, get back into hover mode. Shut up, bro. There we go. To get back into hover mode, all you need to do is just press control before it finishes the thing, and then it'll automatically switch back to hover mode. But I was going to go to F3. Then I was going to go to car options. Open all car doors. Nope, for some reason. Oh, look, the wheels. What the? That is some weird stuff. But that... That is, at least that's hidden and not actually seen. members close all the doors. Apparently, helicopters don't have boots because this has the handling of a helicopter while it's flying. And obviously, there's the addition of them. That's something that will have to definitely be tried to be fixed. Definitely have to. But next, go to one. I'll have to reload the scripts to be able to go back into fly mode again, or I could just spawn in. But anyway, home. You can do this. Hang on. Hook holder. Hang on, I'm just gonna make sure I should get it on. Yeah, that's what I wanted. Right. So that's done. Then you get out. And this is what you'll do in the mission that involves this when he's actually coded it. He hasn't coded it yet. And then you go up to it. And then you press tab. Obviously, if the if this wasn't open, hang on. I'll do it again. F, get in. Then I'll take hook off. I'll put hook sideways on. Then I'll obviously get back out again. Up to it. This time it shouldn't bring up that, and then if I press tab, it goes on there. Numpad mode. Oh, hang on, I think I know what that is. So you press tab to enable and disable numpad mode, so if you're going to use a numpad for something else, or you don't have one, then you can do that. I wonder if the hang on. I'm just gonna switch back to numpad mode because that's a lot easier because I'm used to it and it's a lot more like a thing. But anyway, time traveling. I wonder if it's coded in, but the script. Sorry, the license plate and. Here when it's time travel back and they're all flopping around again. Idiots. Oh my God. Is it coded in? Yeah, let's see. The hook should be gone. No, that is not coded in yet. That hook should have gone, and so should the license plate should have as well. Shut up, Ray. Right, go back to the original one. Yeah, there's no caveat. Then the next thing was this. Get out. Weird door, didn't let me out. But I went through it. Press R, and then you got RC mode, which is no one in the car, and there's a red dot to show exactly where the person is. Right. Again, this isn't part of a different mod, this boost thing. then basically you're here. And then that car went back to... Oh, hang on. I'll need to... No, I won't need to. Sorry.
Dickie, I hear you and the Irish have got your hands on Ancelotti's daughter. Well, this is you. It wouldn't be...
Shut up. Right. I don't think I'll get that phone call anymore now. So that's good. Right. Okay, then. Let's hope this works properly. Go! Yeah, I'll just use that for a bit. Go, go, go! Go, 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 go! I'm gone. I've gone! Yeah, those sounds are really loud. There we go. I actually didn't know where that was. But it's here. And it's actually time traveled in and moved as well, because there was a bit of a bug. The last script set I had before I did a lot of modifications, it just sort of hovered there. But it's pretty good, isn't it? Ah, and the license plate's gone as well. Look, it's gone. Gone. Actually, I want to do this. Spurn. BTTF. 2H. Oh, what the? Eee. There you go. Huh, yeah, there's no collision box on these wheels. Because it didn't work with the collision box. Obviously the headlights are smashable. Blue circuits there. There's the windscreen. Just gonna do this. I don't want to be able to be killed easily. For some reason the door, there we go, the door window smashed. The boot, for some reason, isn't a boot, which is kind of annoying. And then, I'm just gonna get in it. I can't get in it. That looks like orange flares coming out the back. Pretty awesome, because the helicopter has like the best sort of gonna blow up sort of. Gonna blow up the best sort of thing ever. Yeah, I was just gonna wait while that time was over. Lol. The blue coils are still on and the wheels. Oh, so that's what that did. The very thing that made the wheels work when the car's burning makes the wheels look really weird. Where are the cops? Oh, the cops are there. Pop. Pop. I'm sorry, cops. I'm gonna lose you, like, really easily. Go! Ah, tie popped. Just go! I can escape these cops really easily! I can escape these cops real easily. If you didn't hear it, that's all I'm saying it for. Yeah, that kind of needs to be fixed. Also, I'm pretty sure that if I go up to here, and in 1 second... That was... What? Yo, bro. What's with the hat? What's with the hook? You spawned in with a hook. No, you ain't supposed to spawn in with a hook. Also, I'm pretty sure that you can send... Hang on. Wait there. Let me try something. Let's go to error. I wonder if he's actually coded this in. God. Yeah, I crashed again. Now what I was meant to do is go out here, press 2, because that's my favorite of the 3. I like the wheels on 3. And I like them all because they all have their own unique thing, and I like the hover one because I actually spent a lot of time with it trying to get it to work. But right now to go to error like I was meant to be doing. Help! Get help! Shut up. But anyway, let's go. This should work. I'm not sure if he's coded it in yet. Yeah, the car is dead, but it's also completely go through, so you can anything goes through. Yeah. Okay, with this, I've noticed a little bit of a bug. And that looks awesome. ~5_9? That's pretty good. But the bug straight away is the yellow thing should say where I've been. And that hasn't actually done that. And that should be fixed when you get this. But what this was meant to do was take me to an area where there's nothing. So I could do this easy. Right, anyway. What I was showing you in the first place is this. Stop here. Get out. I want to see how many things I can send back. One. Right, so this will be the first one. Sorry, I don't want to send it to error. I'm going to send it to... ...12. 12, 25, 1, 2, 3, 4. Right, here's one. So one's gone back. And it's going to December 25th. 00:00. Now I'm going to send this one back to the same time. Actually. I'm going to send this back to 1 second after. Oh, wait. I've just realized I'm not using a RC mode, I'm using normal mode. Haha. They scream at anything. Next. Go. That one. It says 2 in the corner. Sent back. It tells me the date time. I'm going to send back 5 for this test. Oops. So it's 12.02, and then 12.04 will be the last one. So that one's gone. So that one's gone. 3. Date and destination time. Send this one back as well. So this is 4. Confused. It time traveled, but it didn't time travel. Let's try again. Well, there's the bug. Okay, well, I'm gonna go to... Yeah, that should also not happen. You get the picture. Crashed again. And, well, you can set, you're supposed to be able to send absolutely loads of DeLoreans back to, or forward in time, and then meet up with them. But obviously needs to be fixed because that didn't actually happen. And we'll try doing this again, right? There, so I've done that. And then I do this. Right. There we go, I did it, I opened it, and it refueled properly. And then if you press the button again, it doesn't actually refuel. Also, if you press... What was that? Well, if you press the star, and you turn instant mode on, that sounds really weird. But, anyway... I'm going to show you how dark it is if I travel to night time. I'm not going to use the boost. Hey, look how dark it is. Yeah, it's very dark, isn't it? Yeah, you didn't see that, but the animation actually did happen again. Right, so... Oh, hang on. That's weird. some reason the numpad isn't working, so I'm going to have to use that. Right, numpad on. I'll go to 10 a.m. That, so I'm back in daylight. I'm going to try and show you this again. Hopefully it works this time. This time, if you didn't hear it again because of the sounds. Also, if you the sparks don't happen, if you don't have the fuel thing, so I'm just gonna go up to speed and it should show the coils. Oh, I think I know why. Because there's been some recent changes in the models recently. It's set it to extra 9, blah, some other stuff. Now that definitely isn't showing. So what it's meant to be is it's meant to be red coils instead of blue coils. Because it's a dealer kit version, and look at the wheels. They're all actual 3D textures, and that's just because of a thing that Dima did. But it's awesome. And then, if you want to get out of here like a pro, you do this. You press this. You fly up. This is the end of the video, by the way. You fly up. You don't bother about the lights under there because they'll be fine when you're using it. You refuel. That will be openable. That will open when you use it. You do this. That will make the sound when you press it. Doesn't always make a sound. And then you... And then you do that. And then you've time traveled. And you can't actually get the camera in front of you, so you can't actually fly towards it. Yeah. So I'll see you in my next video, guys, whenever that will be, and it probably will be in the summer holidays. And that's about it for now. Thanks for watching. I've been Kiddabob Stamp, and I will see you next time. I totally just saw Kurt Max. Outro. Welcome back to the Sarcastic Adventures, where I screwed up. Already. Okay, anyway. So yes, I am working on the... because I used it on StarCraft. Yeah, anyway. I was getting a lot of my own coal out. You may... Now I need to wait for my...